Greetings, this is Father Michael with our Word of the Week. This week's word is... Oh! Oh? Oh. Not perhaps a word, a letter, but an exclamation as we prepare for the coming of Jesus at Christmas. Advent takes a turn in this second half. From December 17th and this weekend until the day of Christmas itself, we look forward not to the second coming of Christ, as we've been doing up until this point, but we turn now to the historical remembrance and rejoicing of who Christ is for us, born in the stable as a young babe. And on each one of these days, from December 17th until December 25th, we look at an aspect in which the Christ child fulfills one of the prophecies. And each one of these themes, or each one of these insights into the Christ child, comes in the form of an antiphon called the O antiphons. And it's that sense in which the prophets of old saw in the promise of Messiah God's coming to heal and restore human nature, to call human beings back to the promises and the covenant God has for us. Now, we know these very easily or familiarly from the song and the hymn, O come, Emmanuel. And that, in fact, is the last antiphon we celebrate the day before Christmas Eve. We say, O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel. That idea of Emmanuel, God with us, is what comes to fulfillment in the birth of the Christ child. But there's actually a number of other days as well. And the way to remember each successive days is through a little medieval an acronym or acrostic that lets us know. E-R-O-C-R-A-S. Two words. E-R-O-C-R-A-S, which means coming. So in Latin, that phrase might be translated, tomorrow I will come. Tomorrow I will come. And each letter points out one of these themes or one of these characteristics that the Christ child, the Messiah, will have. And it starts in reverse order. So E is Emmanuel, the last day. But working all the way back, we start with S, C-R-A-S. And S stands for Sapientia, O wisdom from on high. And the next day on the 18th is A, Adonai, Lord, ruler of all. This Christ child will be a ruler, one who is sent as Lord. R, this is radix or root, the root of Jesse's stem. Perhaps you've seen Jesse trees or ways in which we see Christ is fully human, having human ancestry and a genealogy and lineage all the way back until Abraham. C, which stands for clavis or key of David, which unlocks the storehouse to the treasures of the king, to the treasures of God, the Father. O, which is Oriens, or East, or particularly with reference to the sun, that dawn from on high, the radiant dawn. Perhaps my favorite Advent hymn, the O Radiant Dawn that we sing here at St. Dominic's, the James McMillan arrangement. O Radiant Dawn that enlightens us, that guides us in every way. The second R, which is Rex, or King, that this baby will be a kind of King and bring the kingdom of God to earth. And then finally, E for Emmanuel, God with us. Each of these, Sapientia, Adonai, Radix, Clavis, Oriens, Rex, and Emmanuel, point out who this Christ child is. And perhaps you might give thought to each one of these as we celebrate during the week. For me, what stands out in this moment is the clavis, that key of David. We know God has good things in store for us, great gifts. And so we say in these final week before Christmas, O come, Emmanuel. For when we do, we will rejoice, rejoice. Emmanuel will come to you, O Israel. Amen. Amen.